Well, the past 24 hours have not been great, if you're an OU fan. And we have to deal with this situation now with Rodney Anderson. And I almost made a video last night, and I wasn't going to say anything specific or make any declarations, but it's just, I just wanted to hear more. And granted, we've got more information somewhat, but it's still kind of out there. For those who don't know, who live under a rock, or that one guy who complained about me putting the score of the Big 12 championship game in the recap video like 24 hours later after, you know, everyone knew what the game was. What's up with that? But, so allegedly, Rodney Anderson committed sexual assault, allegedly. This event supposedly happened on the 16th of November, a couple days before the Kansas game. Met a girl at a bar. Some buddy said, hey, like, you should give her a ride home. According to the report, he did. Supposedly, something went down. Maybe not. Don't know. Because it's a he said, she said right now. And a VPO, or a victim protection order, was issued yesterday, Monday. And that's where we're at right now. There's going to be a court date on the 18th of December, and we'll have something more definitive by then. So it's going to be a long couple weeks, more than likely. But according to Rodney Anderson literally started a Twitter to proclaim his innocence. And because he hasn't been, he's not a Twitter guy. And I don't blame him. Because I've seen Twitter the past 24 hours. I've seen message boards the past 24 hours. And all I can say is that, you know, he claims his innocence. He claims he doesn't claim he has proof of his innocence, but he claims he has proof of the alleged victim wanting to hang out many times afterwards. And the claim is that this only happened, complaint only took place because he denied her advances of wanting to be in a relationship. That's where we're at. Whether that's true or not, I don't know. But a lot of people feel confident that there's proof of this. What proof? I don't know. You would have to assume if there is any proof, it's text messages, voicemails, DMs on Facebook or Twitter, you know, or you know, witnesses to said conversations, whatever. So this really sucks right now. And, you know, look, I'm going to say I am not worried from a football perspective right now. I know we could argue how important Rodney Anderson was. That's irrelevant at this point because end of the day, the game's going to happen with or without him. So, and I will get back to football eventually. But what I am really, really praying from OU fans out there, please, I know I'm preaching mostly to the choir here, but please, people, do not victim shame, blame, look up personal info on this person, dig up, just do not smear this person's name. I know there's guys out there who are thinking, well, if she's lying, so therefore we have to, no, you're making it worse, and it doesn't help the situation. It does not help at all. And I want to address something else here that I've been seeing. And it drives me insane. I've heard this narrative before, whether it's OU or other places who are, you know, rooting for their guy. Just because the victim in question didn't form a complaint till 3 weeks after the fact doesn't mean it didn't happen. Okay? I know you think that guys have this thing where it's like, well, if it happened that day, she should have reported that day. That's not how it works, guys. That is not how it works. Most cases like this, of sexual assault or rape, they don't go reported because the victim feels shame, they're frightened, they're scared, and this woman who's like surrounded by this giant that is the OU athletic program or any other athletic program like this, It's like, oh, you're going to go after what, like, oh, you're going to go after one of our star players? That's the kind of shit they would have to put up with. And so, just because it was a few weeks later, doesn't mean it didn't happen. I'm not saying it did happen either. Facts. Deal with facts. So, with that being said, I hope for the best, preparing for the worst. And, you know, what sucks is, you know, we're going to have to wait a couple weeks and OU's going to do their own investigation. And look, this is opinion time. No matter how this turns out, I do not expect Rodney Anderson to be playing football for OU at the Rose Bowl or any other game for a while. I just don't. And I know you're saying, what if he's like, and look, I might be wrong on that, okay? I could be 100% wrong, but I do not foresee it happening right now. So if your mindset is like football, prepare yourself for it's going to be Abdul Adams and Trey Sermon. It's going to be the Abdul Adams Trey Sermon show, which is not a bad show to watch if you've seen them play at their best this year. So it's not like they can't handle the load. But I want to believe Rodney Anderson. I really do. But people are going to bring up Joe Mixon, and everyone's going to like line up comments saying, Joe Mixon, Joe Mixon, Joe Mixon. You know what? Go ahead. Be a moron. Because that has nothing. One has nothing to do with the other. One is a completely different instance. And whatever. Go ahead. Be a moron and talk about Joe Mixon. Talk about Dorial Green Beckham, because I know there's people who want to do that too. Because he didn't do anything when he was at OU. It was what he did at Missouri, and he basically came here to practice for a year and then took off for the NFL. That was his crime. So, anyway, I'm getting off on a tangent on that crap. It's like the worst thing that happened this year was it was Baker grabbing his crotch on the sideline during the Kansas game, and it's like, ugh. And you know, that was old news based on recent incident. By recent news in college football, all the coaching changes and all the fiascos going on elsewhere. It just sucks, man. And this is going to be hovering over everything after an amazing year, and everything was going great, and then this happens. So, again, hope for the best. Prepare for the worst, and if he's guilty, he's got to go. Plain and simple. If not, I don't know. Like, I think something, honestly, my personal opinion, I think the truth lies somewhere in the middle on this, and at the end of the day, we'll see what happens. But until then, do not expect Rodney Anderson to be playing football anytime soon, and go from there. And again, I can't stress, don't be that guy that looks up court documents, digs up personal info, because don't be dude bro detective lawyer on the message boards. I've seen plenty of that the past 24 hours, and I just roll my eyes. Don't be that guy. Please. I beg of you. That's all I got. Y'all have a good one, and hopefully some resolution will come to this sooner than later. And we'll get back to talking about football. That's all I got on this. Y'all have a good one. Later.